Meanwhile, tensions simmer at the G20 summit in India. This as the top diplomats of Russia and the US meet face-to-face for the first time since Moscow's invasion of Ukraine. US Secretary of State Antony Blinken says he told Russian Foreign Minister Sergei Lavrov to end the war during the unscheduled encounter. He also told Lavrov to reverse what he called the Kremlin's irresponsible decision to suspend their nuclear pact.
Mutual compliance is in the interest of both our countries. It's also what people around the world expect from us as nuclear powers. I told the foreign minister that no matter what else is happening in the world or in our relationship, the United States will always be ready to engage and act on strategic arms control, just as the United States and the Soviet Union did even at the height of the Cold War. I told the foreign minister what I and so many others said last week at the United Nations and what so many G20 foreign ministers said today. End this war of aggression. Engage in meaningful diplomacy that can produce a just and durable peace.
The U.S. Justice Department rejects former President Donald Trump's claim of immunity from lawsuits connected to the deadly January 6th Capitol assault. The Court of Appeals for the District of Columbia had asked the Justice Department to weigh in as it decides whether to allow civil lawsuits against Trump. According to the DOJ, incitement of imminent private violence does not fall within the scope of a president's official duties. Trump has argued that he was acting in his official capacity as president when he told a crowd of his supporters to fight like hell ahead of the congressional certification of Joe Biden's electoral victory.
Vietnam has a new president. Vo Van Thuong from the ruling Communist Party was elected president Wednesday in a reshuffle of Vietnam's top leadership amid a sweeping anti-graft campaign. Thuong's election follows the forced resignation in January. His predecessor was blamed for the wrongdoings of officials under his control. In his first speech to the parliament as new president, Thuong said he will continue to fight against corruption.
I will do anything that is of benefit to the people and avoid anything that is harmful to the people. I will be determined in the fight against corruption and negative phenomena.
Malaysian Prime Minister Anwar Ibrahim warns against sacrificing moral uprightness for economic growth and what he calls misplaced nationalism. Anwar spoke Thursday at the University of the Philippines, which granted him an honorary doctorate. Willard Chang reports.
It was a homecoming for Malaysian Prime Minister Anwar Ibrahim as he visited the University of the Philippines, Diliman. As a young man, Anwar was a frequent visitor and consulted with renowned scholar Cesar Adib Mahul. As Anwar returns to the campus as the leader of Malaysia, he was awarded an honorary doctorate in recognition of his commitment for the pursuit of justice and democratic ideals and the attainment of a more inclusive and pluralistic Malaysia, even at great personal cost. An admirer of Rizal, Prime Minister Anwar was also cited for his scholarship on the life and works of the Philippine national hero.
Maraming salamat mula sa kaibuturan ng aking puso.
Anwar says Rizal's writings remain relevant and warned against falling for the comfort zone of what Rizal identified as routine.
Even worse, routine has allowed the world to fall behind our future potential. Routine tells us to be divided in opinion and to hate one another, fueled by the convenience of and routine of social media, fake news, misplaced nationalism, and certainly Islamophobia.
He urged ASEAN not to remain silent in the face of human rights violations in Myanmar, saying the principle of non-interference should not be used as an excuse for indifference.
When I mentioned in Bangkok recently about the need to temporarily carve out Myanmar on account of the blatant human rights violations, it was said in the larger context of the imperative to stay true to one of the key ideals of ASEAN, which is nothing less than to stand for the cause of justice and the rule of law.
He urged leaders of the region to uphold justice, compassion, and moral uprightness as they pursue economic growth.
Economic growth, no matter how robust and the accumulation of wealth, no matter how vigorous, should never be attained on the sacrificial altar of justice, compassion, and moral uprightness. I believe that it is only when faith and religious practice, as underscored with justice and compassion, find its convergence with economic prosperity, will society stay on the path of real and meaningful progress.
Before the program ended, Anwar joined the UP community in singing the university hymn, congratulating the Filipino people as well as the university for standing for democracy and accountability.
You have demonstrated beyond a shadow of doubt you are able to confront arrogant powers and show to us in ASEAN and beyond that defeat in times of trouble is not an option.
Following their meeting in Malacanang on Monday, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. and First Lady Liza Marcos gifted Anwar a 1909 edition of Rizal's novel Noli Me Tangere and a brass card holder made by Cebu artisans for Anwar's wife, Dr. Juan Asisa Juan Ismail. Willard Cheng, ABS-CBN News.
The Malaysian government is willing to settle with other banks involved in the 1MDB scandal if the proposals are reasonable. In an exclusive interview with ANC, Prime Minister Anwar Ibrahim, who is also finance minister, said they don't expect to recover all the funds that were lost, but the deal should be fair. Two Abu Dhabi state funds embroiled in the scandal recently agreed on a $1.8 billion settlement with the Malaysian Sovereign Fund and the Ministry of Finance to end a legal dispute in London. Anwar has also asked Goldman Sachs to pay up after the bank admitted its role in the scandal. The 1MDB scandal saw billions of dollars siphoned from the Malaysian Sovereign Fund, which led to the ouster of Najib Razak as prime minister. The fund remains the subject of corruption and money laundering investigations in several countries.
It could not have happened in that scale if the international financial institutions like Goldman Sachs is not complicit to the crime. So it's a tough stance. And we cleared it to the Goldman Sachs. And it's not right for you to say now we'll pay you some minor compensation. Yes, it was done by the previous administration, which I think was clearly not complicit, but at least certainly didn't focus on these issues. And I've changed. I've dismissed the legal team and the entire team and work again, because I think I owe it to the Malaysian people. I mean, why do we need to pay billions of dollars to the complicit crime of others? So I take that position, and we are reopening, of course, the case and negotiations with Goldman Sachs. And they can't say, well, it's over. No, it's not over.
You can catch Karen Davila's exclusive interview with Prime Minister Anwar later at 8 a.m. on ANC's Head Start.